Hello and welcome. Today I have some awesome news regarding Oculus's plans for face and eye tracking, the V29 update with some new hidden features, and an update on older features I've already shown you. Earlier this month, Mark Zuckerberg announced in an interview that they could imagine Oculus adding eye and face tracking to a Quest Pro. Now we have proof that they are already working on it. In fact, they actually already started with it in the V28 update and just added some code and calibration in V29. You can see it for yourself by typing the following ABB command: ADB shell service list. I personally think that face and eye tracking could be huge for social VR applications, but with Facebook doing it, there are of course a lot of privacy concerns. Next, we have an internal testing menu accidentally left in the V29 update. It's quite surprising to see that in a public release, because it isn't something that will ever be released to the public. If you want to test this feature yourself, you can sideload my app VR Launcher onto your Quest and select Dog Food Hub. On the first page of the Dog Food Hub, we can see some general information about our device, like the serial number or firmware version. The next page shows us which versions of system packages we have installed and if they're currently running or not. Then we have the developer settings, which basically do the same as the normal ones in the normal settings. And last but not least, we have a page called Dog Food Assignments, where we have the possibility to check for assignments, but that doesn't seem to do anything right now. Next, we have the Infinite Office Settings panel. In it, we have the possibility to view instructions on how to test Infinite Office. We can pair a keyboard or a gamepad via Bluetooth and report bugs. Then there's a feature section, which includes a version of the Oculus browser with the ability to have multiple windows, the pass-through home environment we already got in V29, standard hand tracking, and the V29 file manager. We now also have access to the Guardian Intrusion Detection settings page, where we can activate it and adjust the area and boundary sensitivity. From my test, it doesn't seem to do anything, but it could also be that I messed something up. Now we come to a feature I had already told you about in a prior video. That is the color filter accessibility feature, which shifts colors so that they are perceivable by people with different color blindnesses. Volga Exor, I'm sorry if I'm butchering that name right now, a graphics coder at Oculus, hinted at other accessibility options being worked on right now. Other than that, I've also found a menu that will be used for phone notifications and pass-through portal, but both menus currently don't do anything for me. Thanks for watching this video, I'll see you next time, and in case you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comment section.